Good afternoon, everyone. It's a pleasure to be in this afternoon with you in this webinar. In this afternoon, we wanted to be reinforced about the Active English Methodology Introduction. It's all about the first module of the course given by CoreFO. So, oh my God. My name is Jean Carlos. I am gonna be with you in this afternoon. This is the agenda for today. here there are 7 points. Okay, in this part it's necessary to remember what is the most important role like a teacher. This is a great video about what makes a good teacher great. In this video, we can hear and see a man talked about that some of us are so analytical about knowledge, and it is important to understand that learning comes in different ways, and not everything has to be taught in the same boring manner. We need to listen to our students and respect their learning ways. We have the opportunity to learn with our students because we learn something new every day. We could bring material to provoke their thinking. In this video, there is a line: great teachers make themselves humble before their students. Well, you could see this video in the future when you can see again this workshop. Well, but how active English methodology can help us to be a great teacher? Well, there have been several approaches and methods to improve our methods for teaching English as a second language. But the active English methodology helps us to teach English through fun exercises, using team words with our students, memory games, and others. Active English is a teaching learning methodology based on brain and pedagogical research, and is regularly updated in order to students' needs. In this first model, we need to understand these elements. For the first unit is necessary to have a good positive attitude. It's necessary to know our brain and how can the active English methodology we can apply in our teaching. Well, the first is the power of language. The power of language includes the importance of using clear and direct language that is free or sarcasm, using good words, tone of voice is essential, our facial expression also, and obviously our body posture. We can help to put a good posture and to get a good connection with our students. It's necessary to avoid the shaming and the judging children. Keep the focus on the positive behavior that we want to see in our students. Create a positive learning environment includes to use a power of language. For example, the kind of language is to, we can replace the negative phrases or negative statements with more positive ideas or positive learning attitudes. For example, in this poster, we can see two different statements, two different attitudes. For example, in the right, in the left side, we can see negative phrases, negative statements. We can replace these statements by positive attitudes. Well, the positive attitude involves the positive atmosphere. What is this positive atmosphere? Well, this stimulates the desire to learn because it eliminates learning blocks and improves relationship in the classroom, as well as generating an overall feeling of ease. We can create a positive learning when we put inside of the classroom and both sides of this with positive quotes and posters worked for them. Creating a positive learning environment will optimize students' learning, help us build a cohesive classroom community, and create a pleasant work environment for both we and our students. We have, well, the most of us, we don't have a special classroom for English teaching, but it's necessary have a portable case, or maybe put in a special part of the wall in our classroom their works worked for them in some topic in our classroom, especially when they are in primary school, in kindergarten school. Is necessary set up also the chairs and the desk according their classroom, according the large class, if the amount of the students. Now it's necessary to remember and recognize the characteristics of our amazing brain. We have a marvelous brain. In this part, we recognize two hemispheres, the left and the right. This hemisphere is considered, there is a bridge between these hemispheres. It is called the corpus callosum. The corpus callosum is a part of our brain where it happened the transfer, or maybe the joining of the different activities using each characteristic of these different hemispheres. For example, we have a typical exercise with the left and the right hemispheres. Is look at the chart and say the color, but not say the word. No, it's a typical. When we do this exercise, we can see the difference there is between the right and the left hemispheres. It's an easy and fun exercise for even we can do with our students. Well, It's very practical. It's only say the color, not the word. It's a left and right conflict game. What happened? The conflict. What happens that? Well, our right brain tries to say the color, but our left brain insists of reading the word, which is typical and real also. Well, another characteristic of the learners is when our learners develop more the left or the right hemispheres. We can see these characteristics in these two in the blacks with the black in the bold letters, in the black letters. We can see another characteristic, but related to the learners or our students. Well, if necessary, in this part, let's explore a Corefo English book. Some of you are using these books in this year in order to your experience or maybe in order to your school. But in this year, Corefo presents and introduces in the English world these books. These books are in two levels, in kindergarten and primary school. These competences are developed in each level for the books: oral expression, oral comprehension, written comprehension, written expression. Well, in primary, is also in this opportunity I'm going to explain the primary in primary level. The books have a student book, workbook, teacher guide, and other material are poster, flashcard, vocabulary cards. No, it's vocabulary handouts. There are in the web page. In the web page, there are more material related to the books. Each unit of the book are developed with different competences. For example, in the opening is the oral comprehension competence. There are another, Turn Your Brain On, is another section of the book. I Have Fun with Words, Phonics, Speak Up, English in Action, Enjoy Writing, My Project, Share Your Values, Let's Play, and Let's Remember. In each section, we can see develop different competence. For example, here, if this is the section, the opening section of the book. Each unit has the same structure of the presentation of the unit. We can see first a general picture, and we can see two questions related to the picture. In the right page, in the next page, number 7, we can see three different pictures. But according to the situation, according to the regions of Peru. And after that, we can see another question related to the topic. The topic in this unit is routine, no? A typical day. And we can see the expected learning outcomes in the right side of the page number 7. We can see find out, we can find in a web page more information related to the topic. Here, there in this section, bueno, Turn Your Brain On has two pages, but with different competences developed. For example, here, do you bring out oral comprehension? In page number 8, do you bring on my routine? We can see in this part the vocabulary according to the unit, and 1, 2, and 3 activities according to the competence. In this part is oral comprehension or listening skill, no? Listen and repeat, activity number 1, activity number 2, listen and point to the pictures, and number 3, listen and see. The next page to your brain on is about reading skill. Before that, this section starts with activity number 1 is before the reading. In activity number 2, during the reading, and then finally activity number 3, after the reading. This is the section about turn your brain on. The section have fun with words is related to more vocabulary and how to make a connection between more topics according to the general objective for this unit. We can see the competencies written comprehension developed in three different activities. Listen and repeat, look and complete, listen and read, then point to the picture in activity 3. In the ending of the page, we can see a web page. We can find more activities or more vocabulary to relate this part. This section has fun with words. Phonics is related all about phonics. All the books from first grade to sixth grade, all has this section about phonics. Is oral comprehension competence. Listen and repeat activity 1, 2, or 3. In this case, it's only 2 activities. Well, need more, is 11. Speak up. In here, in this section, speak up also has 2 different pages, oral comprehension, oral expression. Oral comprehension, maybe we're using readings, dialogues, using the readings and dialogues, and the oral expression is only when students speak, no, with and interact with another classmate. Using dialogues, interviews, etc. This is a speak up. Speak up section. Oh my goodness. Oh. English in action. This is the grammar section. It's a part where the grammar is developed in the unit. Simple present tense is in this opportunity the grammar topic. This is the written expression. We can see activity number two, we can see Hanau. This is Hanau is in the Corefo web page. In this case are 3 activities, four activities. In another book are 4 or 3. No more activities in this part. And then your writing, the next page, the next section, and your writing is a pre-writing, number 1, activity number 1, 2, observe and read, number 2, activity 2, and number 3 is a production. Write a sentence about your routine. All these sections are linked in the workbook. We can see the workbook is in the workbook. This is the student book. In the workbook, there are the same sections where we can develop and explore and make more or make more exercises related to the topic. My project in this section is when put their ideas or their situations, their needs, according to their needs. This is a production for them, by them. Share your values is according to the citizenship, the society also, no? Let's play is a session where we can play with their classmate and with their, or maybe including the teacher also. No, let's play. This is a funny game. It's a board game for them. Using vocabulary or structures or grammar structures according to that unit. And let's remember it's a review, no? It's a general review of the topic. Okay, all the books have these sections. But what active English methodology are related with this book? Well, active English methodology have these elements: bridging, mind map, Sciencetopedia, GPR, learning styles, and multiple intelligences. Well, the active English is a interesting methodology because it respects individual learning styles, individual learning ways to learn, their multiple intelligence, our students, and it enhances their academic results, enhances their self-esteem, and their imagination and creativity also. Active English is a supportive, brain-friendly teaching approach involving the learning as a whole, mind, body, and emotion. It's for that it includes these important key elements. The bridging are physical exercises designed to encourage better hemispheric integration, the left and the right hemispheres. There are 15 different exercises, and each exercise is for we can apply for different skills. For example, before reading, we can apply one of these, the correct exercise according to of the bridging. This interesting element of the active English methodology. Another element is the mind map. The mind map we can find in the books, in the workbook. We can see the workbook. May the page of the workbook in this slide make your own mind map according to the topic. It's an example. Our students make extra mind maps in their notebooks according to the topic. For example, we can see the page of the student book that in the section has fun with words. This page is about the vocabulary. We can create a mind map using this vocabulary of this section. Using the activity number one, no? This is the book number fifth grade. Active, the have fun with words section of the fifth grade book. Activity number one, listen, read, and say, no? After this activity, when you do with your our students, we can make with an extra activity in their notebook, make a mind map using this vocabulary, no? Make more, no? According to your needs, according to their likes or dislikes also. And we can see that mind map, in the left side is, well, it's not exactly a mind map, but is a graphic organizer related to the active English methodology. No, using all the key elements of the active English, no, holistic, bringing, movement, multiple intelligences, music, emotional intelligence, learning style, color mind map. It's interesting in this part that mind map needs to get all the basis, all the characteristics of the correct mind map. No, in the next module of the no, the third module is a mind map. We can see more about this key element of the active English. The next is the Sayestopedia. Sayestopedia has three basic steps: introduction, active concept, passive concept, and elaboration of the transfer, the presentation also. The Sayestopedia we can apply overall in the reading. When we can develop the reading skill. In the section Turn Your Brain On our books, we have no readings or dialogues. We can apply the Sayestopedia using the dialogues or the readings in your writing section. In Turn Your Brain On also, in this opportunity, in this example, is a dialogue we can see, no? Ahora, now, these steps or these basic steps we can see, we could see in the module of the Sayestopedia. TPR, we can see in different sections. For example, but in phonics, for example, here in phonics, we can see three different activities. Activity number one, listen and rap. Activity number two, listen to your teacher, match and point. Or number three, listen and point. It includes all about movements, because it's total physical response. Includes also the gesture, the body language, the facial expression also, and extraction or commands in this case, or commands. Learning styles is another key and another important of English. Learning styles are visual, auditory, kinesthetic, visual. Because the learning is only using pictures or movies, and auditory when they can learn effectively with only listening any command, or kinesthetic when our students like to move, like move a lot. Okay, there are different strategies to apply and develop for each learning style. For example, in the book, in the section Speak Up, we can see in the activity number four, listen to your teacher and mind. Listen to your teacher. Listen is auditory. Listen to your teacher is not only auditory, it's visual also, and mind. Entonces, kinesthetic are involved in kinesthetic learning style in this activity. No, this is an example in our book. There are a lot activities like this in the book. Multiple intelligences. Yes, it's possible to develop different multiple intelligences for each one. It was developed by Howard Gardner. He discovered eight different intelligences you can see in this page. The book, in Correfo's book, there are different activities that develops these different multiple intelligences. For example, activity number 3 in the section Speak Up. In this activity, we can see timelines. When we can pull these exercises with our students, we can develop the logical or mathematical intelligence in our students, because it's using the logical and analytical, also analytical part of our brain. We can also, another example could be the Venn diagrams also, no? For finding differences or comparing something, no? Comparing maybe animals or comparing clothing, comparing women and men, etc. In the books, there are a lot of activities that it can develop multiple intelligences. In this part, finally, the kaleidoscope is all the abstract, all the synthesis of the active English methodology. The kaleidoscopio is similar to our lesson plan because it has 3 different moments, like our lesson plans: the presentation, activation, and creative transfer. Bueno, for us, we could be the beginning, the process, and the ending, no? And the ending in our lesson plan. The presentation is where we create a positive learning environment when we start with relaxation activities, using different learning activities in according to the visual, auditory, and kinesthetic activities, or according to the learning styles, is where the teacher presents the class, presents the topic, but in a fun way, to learn the presentation. It's only the interaction is between the teacher and a student, more the teacher, no? Because it's the guy, the facilitator in this part. But it's where the engage with the students in the topic, with the topic for this day. Well, activation is the second part. In activation is a part when the construct of the learning, according to the all vocabulary of the presentation of some grammar, according to a context. Well, the activation is put using different activities, may using games also, using a good atmosphere, using posters, using a power of language, a positive language, also puts the chair in semicircle, is because it facilitates the stimulation of the eye contact, or maybe the everybody in the classroom. So in the activation is when the students develop all challenge, proposal by teacher. And creative transfer is the ending, including the product of the topic according to the topic. The creative transfer is the final part of our lesson plan, and it involves the final product of our students. This part is only a student, could be a role play or a drama, or maybe creative writing according to topic. We can develop different strategies to see the students' understanding of this topic. It's interesting in all this part, the internalization, because the teacher puts the information using the power of language, using the body language, using posters, using the all positive atmosphere according to the topic, according the objective, the learning objective for this day. Well, this is a kaleidoscope. Why? In this moment, this is a time for your questions. This module is only a general view of the Active English introduction. The Active English introduction is not in this year is related to the correct post book. Active English introduction if was given or was brought by CREA, Instituto CREA, Pedagogical Institute CREA. In this institution have developed all these elements, no? All these elements also. And in this year, COREFO and CREA are together. The sum of this relationship is these books. Well, it's time for your question, my dear colleagues. Or maybe a chat or writing your questions. If you're using the books. Okay, well, COREFO English book is a six-level series for elementary students in English. It is based on the active English approach. Well, you see, in this module, you can see this approach involves learning styles, multiple intelligence theory, Sayestopeia method, total physical response, BrainG, mind map. All these key elements are developed using these books by COREFO. Active English approach has been applied in many countries in Europe, no? During more than 20 years ago. It also has got a special section based on content and language in integrated learning CLIL. And all its exercises are towards starters, movers, and flyer level. These books are developed by according to the international examination, the starters, movers, or flyers level according to the level, no? Primary school especially. In primary school. Well, the oral expression and oral comprehension in this competence using the book, the students can communicate ideas and emotion with creativity and cohesion. Also, students can learn English through other areas, no? Using science topics, social topics. Some activities are based on real and meaningful communicative situations, and students understand the main idea and reflect about the communication situation. These are the competences of the area. Okay. Also, competences are written comprehension where students understand and evaluate and judge different texts. No? All activities are based on deciphering the visual, auditory, kinesthetic activities, and other. In this competence, Students can identify meaningful information and reflect about the content. In the written comprehension, is a production of students where students write different texts with coherence and cohesion through a previous process of planning. Students check and reflect about the process in order to improve it. There are more additional material using the web page Corefonet. You can find a lot material. So Corefo English Book promotes positive atmosphere, motivation, the creativity, imagination. Using these books, we can eliminate learning barriers in our students. We can see the opening. Yeah, if you use, no, I don't know if maybe one of you uses the book in this year. I can see any question. I don't know why. Okay. Acá veo Basilia Armas, good evening. Basilia Silva, good evening, Danis. Danis Patsy Rojas, good evening, Gertrudis Tolentino. Jenny Marlene, good evening. Janet Diaz, nice to meet you, all of you. Okay, yes, I saw one question, Danis. It's typical to, maybe it's necessary to plan before the in your lesson plan, what activity are more important or are more important our students' needs. No, according, for example, each page, each section of the book only has three activities, but if you have only maybe develop one, maybe two, the first or the second. You can do, but be careful in the when it's a reading skill or it's a writing skill, because it has a process, no? It has a process before and while and after. It's be careful in this part. It's necessary to develop or maybe modify some activities according to students' needs, Danny. Yes, in the workbook there are a lot of exercises. May if you prefer only make some explanation using the student book, and in the world you could develop exercises direct, no, with your students at the same time, Danis. At the same time, is necessary. Well, you can do some ranging, some activity of the ranging, and relax for relaxing our students, because they are all the day they are sitting, and they obviously they don't like move much to be in this position. It's necessary, no, to move. According to team words, using different team words, we can make team words using colors, using positive sentences or positive quotes. For example, team words is according to the values, no, respect, responsibility. No, don't forget organize our board also. Our board is an important tool for us. No, it's necessary to put in order. In every class, put the board, and they recognize. This is our English teacher board style. English teacher style. Oh, well. In the grammar, it says in sixth grade, it's necessary maybe develop the multiple intelligences. Okay, for example, we can see this. In this part, In this part, we can see the multiple intelligences. Here, this page is related is from fifth grade. Is from fifth grade. Unit number one. English fifth. Okay, fifth grade number one. This is the grammar. We can see grammar between in these books are a. Have a great a high English level, so the grammar is necessary planning using these multiple intelligences. Yes, using naturalistic, logical, mathematical, spatial, musical. For example, in this part, using the timelines, comparing different structure, for example, the simple past the simple past regular with the irregular. We can compare. Another is learning style. Is another resource for developing grammar with six graders, with six learners. The learning style, but I consider that a multiple intelligences is more effective for them, no? Diagrams, Venn diagrams, graphic organizer, mind maps, using grammar mind maps. Yes, we can do using this. You can see this part of multiple intelligences in the sixth model. Of this the Corefo and CREA course, you can see these more activities related to the multiple intelligences. Okay, my dear Janet, in the book you can find a lot of activities, but in fifth and sixth are more activities related to the multiple intelligences. Okay, but games related to the games, we can make elaborate games. Board games is more effective because they can work in group using cards, vocabulary cards, using cards, for example, according to the topic. No, according to the topic, put vocabulary cards, no, interview different questions, no, how often do you like playing the guitar? I don't know, no, vocabulary according to the competence also, no, is to speak clearly, so vocabulary card about the topic, but games. We can play with our students tic-tac-toe using grammar, no? Using, for example, a sentence using the present perfect. If they're correct, okay. Across, no? And an X or a circle. Or, well, the symbol is not that important, but. Games, move. They love move. Students love move. Okay, well, time for your question writing. Well, here there are a lot of reference. You have a module, you have the reference in your module. Review again your module. There are a lot of information. Remember, active English is new for us, maybe, but in Europe, well, it has 20 years ago, no? In Europe, it's applied more or less 20 years ago. So here there is a quote, well, it's in Spanish, si no hay diversión, entonces le estás dando paso a la distracción. Si hay motivación, entonces él o ella o los comprenderán la sesión. This is my quote, my personal quote, and it was a really, really pleasure to be this afternoon with you. Well, I am Shin Carlos. I am humble. I am a colleague with you, and I hope that you understand this afternoon about the Active English Introduction Model first. Thanks, Corefo. Thanks, CREA Institute, for to give me this opportunity to share these ideas with another colleague. Good afternoon. Good evening. Oh my, no, good afternoon.